Welcome to Information Service Engineering. This is lecture number 13, ISE Applications, part 1. In this section of the lecture, we want to focus on data acquisition, which is one of the, let's say, foremost and first things you have to do for data analysis and subsequent knowledge discovery and knowledge mining. Okay, data acquisition. We want, as you see already here from the graphics, stay in the realm of soccer or football. And of course, we are dealing here with women football because it's more interesting and not so well known. Okay, as you know already, how do we start if we want to do data acquisition and we want to get the data this time from Wikidata, not from Wikipedia? We have to look up a sample, a prominent example. And like last time here again, we look for Marta as one of the most popular women soccer players of all times, and we look this up in Wikidata. So you have the link here and you have the page here and you can look it up to find out what interesting facts we might find about Marta Vieira da Silva. Okay, for that, let's do a brief recap what we see there. You know already that how Wikidata pages are organized. You have here statements which consist of course, the subject is always the page you're looking at, and then you have here the properties, and then you have here property values. But sometimes, of course, these property values here, for example, that she's a team member of Vasco da Gama, they can be, let's say, complemented with qualifiers, which say for exactly this fact that she's a member of the sports team Vasco da Gama, you have a start and an end time. So from 2000 to 2002, she was team member there, and there she played 16 matches and she scored here, for example, 4 goals. These are qualifiers, these are statements. This is interesting data and we want to collect this from Wikidata. However, we do not exactly know how to access data about the statement and about the qualifiers. We only know how to access exactly these objects we have here in the regular statements, not the qualifiers. We need different namespaces for that, and I will tell you how this works. Okay, so we access the data via different namespaces that exists for our properties. The property we are looking here first is here members of sports team. This is P 54, and if we use the standard namespace WDT, you have heard and seen this already in Wikidata, this connects an item to a specific value. If you want to get the information that somebody has played or is member of the sports team CR Vasco da Gama, then of course you use WDT P54 and then you get the team statement for a specific player. And here Q228616 is of course Marta. Okay, this we already knew. Now it's becoming more interesting. If you want to get the entire statement back, there you have to use another property. You have to use the P property. With the P property, so the P namespace, and you connect here Marta with P namespace and then property 54, which is team member. You get all of the statements you have here back, and then you can put them in another variable, which is called here the variable team statement. And for each statement, you might then access the qualifiers related to that statement, because these qualifiers refer not only to Marta, to the subject, but to a specific fact that she is a sports member or was a member of a sports team of Vasco da Gama. So now let's get the information of a qualifier value that is associated to a specific statement. For that, we need an additional namespace. The namespace is PQ. And PQ connects a statement with a qualifier value. We have already determined all the team statements here in the previous here statement we had made. And thereby, we can use the team statement here as a subject and then connect it with a property we are looking here at, and therefore we are interested, for example, in the property number of points, goals, set scored. And this is the property P1351 connected to this new namespace PQ, And then the output would be here 4, for example. For another one, it would here be 10. For another one, it would be 19. This is then the statement value we get. Okay, this only as a prerequisite that you really understand the complex Sparkle query we want to create to harvest and to get first the data for our data acquisition task. Okay, what can we score? What can we get from Wikidata? We can find out in how many different teams our player has played. We can find out how many matches she has played. We can find out how many goals she scored, as we have already seen. We might find out, probably, a player has additional occupations besides being a player. And we can find out about additional citizenship. So, for example, if a player is rather popular, it's rather likely that, for example, he also changes team and might have different citizenships during that time. And of course, one indicator for popularity is, of course, the number of Wikipedia pages on which the player occurs. Somebody who is only regionally known would occur then only in a regional Wikipedia and has not many other Wikipedia pages. But internationally known, renowned soccer players, they would be in many Wikipedia players. So this is some indicator for popularity. Of course, we could also record in which positions a player has played. And of course, information about the weight, the height as well as of the birth date. And to get all this information, of course, we have to figure out a very complicated Sparkle query that you see here on the next page. So you see here we select lots of stuff. And of course, we want to group this also that we get all the goals. So we want to have one column where we have the entire number of goals that a player has scored. And for that, we have to add all of the team statements where, you know, number of goals for a specific team, they have to be add up together. So this is here, for example, some goals that we have here. So we sum up all of the goals and we sum up all of the matches played that we get the total number of matches played here. Therefore, we have to group this then in the end by the player. So what we have here in this statement is, of course, we want to find out, of course, you know, is it a soccer player? So is it a female, woman, soccer association player? So this is the first thing we want to find out. Here we get then the team statement, as in the example. We get the height, we get the weight, the position played, the birth date of the person, the citizenship, all the occupations. We get here via Wikibase site links all of the Wikipedia pages that we are interested in. And then for the team statement that we selected here, we have then to use another here namespace PQ. We want to have the number of goals and the number of matches played here. In the end, we filter out, of course, we want to have the name of the player and we only want to have this name then here probably, or then no, it's not for the player, it's for the position played. And for that, of course, we only want to have the English name of the position where the player has played. So you can try it out. This is a complex Sparkle query, which might also require lots of time. So therefore, I have prepared it already for you. So you see it here. And the result of that Sparkle query then can also be simply extracted and put together there in a Google Sheet. We have prepared the spreadsheet already for you and put the data in there, and we can have a quick look. So you have here columns with the number of teams the player has played, with the number of total goals, so they are summed up, as well as the number of matches played. Then we have the total number of citizenships, the height, the weight, the position played, the birth date, the number of jobs besides being a soccer player, and of course the importance as number of Wikipedia pages referring exactly to that player to get a notion of the importance. Okay, so we have the data. Of course, you have to look on your data and analyze it, so to see whether, you know, you might have missing values or you might have noise in there. So I save, you know, the entire cleanup, so the data that you are dealing with is more or less clean, so you have good data here. So what we do next, of course, is then We will have a closer look on our data, and for that you have to learn how to read box plots, which is an interesting and really sophisticated means to get more information out of your data and to visualize that kind of information. But this we will do in the next section of the lecture.